Hello everyone, we are giving our presentation on Frangipani, a scalable distributed file system for CSC 707 distributed computing system course. Me Asirabra will give a short overview of Frangipani and the structures, and our other members will discuss the disk layout, logging and recovery, the log service, backup and performance. So without any further delay, let's start the presentation. Please, next slide. So what is Frangipani? Frangipani is a distributed file system. So what is the purpose of the distributed file system? The purpose of a distributed file system is to allow users of physically distributed computers to share data and resources by using a common file system. Similarly, Frangipani is a scalable distributed file system that manages a collection of disks on multiple machines as a single shared pool of storage. The machines are assumed to be under a common administration and to be able to communicate securely. Please, next slide. Okay. Next, come to the structure. First, come to the Frangipani layering. It is relatively easy to build because it has only two layers structure. The lower layer is Petal. What is Petal? A Petal is a distributed storage service that provides incrementally scalable, highly available, and automatically managed virtual disks. In the upper layer, multiple machines run the same Frangipani file system code on the top of a shared Petal virtual disk, using a distributed log service to ensure the coherence. Multiple interchangeable Frangipani servers provide access to the same files by running on the top of a shared Petal virtual disk, coordinating their actions with logs to ensure the coherence. Petal and the log services are also distributed for scalability, fault tolerance, and load balancing. Next, come to the Frangipani structure. The components of Frangipani do not have to be assigned to the machine in exactly is shown in the picture. The Petal and the Frangipani servers need not to be on the separate machines. It could be make sense for every Petal machines to run Frangipani as well, particularly in an installation where the Petal machines are not heavily loaded. The distributed log service is independent of the rest of the systems. In the picture, you can show one log server as running on each Petal server machine, but they could just as well run on the Frangipani hostess or any other available machines. So next come to the components. So user program access Frangipani through the standard operating system called interfaces. Program running on different machines all can see the same files and their views are coherent. That is, changes made to a file or a directory or one machine are immediately visible to others. The Frangipani file server module on each machine run within the operating system kernel. It registers itself with the kernel's file system switch as one of the available file system implementations. The file server module uses the kernel's buffer pool to cache data from recently used files. It reads and writes Petal virtual disk using the local Petal device driver. The device driver hides the distributed nature of Petal, making the Petal look like an ordinary local disk to the higher layers of the operating system. The driver is responsible for contacting the correct Petal server and failing over to another when necessary. All the file servers read and write the same file system data structures on the shared Petal disk. The logs are kept in Petal so that when a Frangipani server caches, another server can access the log and run the recovery. The Frangipani servers have no need to communicate directly with one another. They communicate only with the Petal and the log services. This keeps the server addition, deletion, and the recovery very simple. Next, Shafat Mahmood will discuss the disk layout. Thank you.
Thank you, Raghib. I'm Shafat Mahmood. I'm going to talk about the disk layout. So the first thing is simplifying the data structures. Frangipani uses the large sparse disk address space of Petal to simplify its data structures. A Petal virtual disk has 2 to the power 64 bytes of address space. Petal commits a physical disk space to virtual addresses only when they are written. Each 64 kilobyte range of addresses into 2 to the power 16 and a plus 1 into 2 to the power 16 in which some data has been written and not decommitted has 64 kilobyte of physical disk space allocated to it. Next, I'm going to talk about dividing the virtual disk space. There are five fragments in the disk space. The first region stores shared configuration parameters and housekeeping information. 1 terabyte of virtual space for the region is allowed. The second region stores logs. Each frangipani server obtains a portion of the space to hold its private log. 1 terabyte for this region is reserved, partitioned into 256 logs. The third region is used for allocation of bitmaps to describe which blocks in the remaining regions are free. The bitmap region is 3 terabyte long. The fourth region holds inodes. Each file needs an inode to hold its metadata. Two symbolic links store their data directly in the inode. Inodes are 512 bytes long. 1 terabyte of inode space is allocated, allowing room for 2 to the power 31 inodes. The fifth region holds small data blocks, each 4 kilobyte in size. The first 64 kilobyte of a file are stored in small blocks. If a file grows to more than 64 kilobyte, the rest is stored in one large block. 1 terabyte of address space is reserved for every large block. Now I'm going to talk about resolving the trade-offs. Disk layout policy of using 4 kilobyte blocks can suffer from more fragmentation. Also, allocating 512 bytes per inode is somewhat wasteful of space. The current scheme limits frangipani to slightly less than 2 to the power 64 large files, where a large file is any bigger than 64 kilobyte. Also, no file can be larger than 16 small blocks plus one large block. Should the 2 to the power 64 bytes address space limit prove inadequate, a single frangipani server can support multiple frangipani file systems on multiple virtual disks. Please change the slide. So now I'm going to talk about logging and recovery. Use of write-ahead redo logging of metadata. Frangipani uses write-ahead redo logging of metadata to simplify failure recovery and improve performance. User data is not logged. Each frangipani server has its own private log in Petal. When a frangipani file server needs to make a metadata update, it first creates a record describing the update and appends to its log in memory. Only after a log record is written to Petal does the server modify the actual metadata in its permanent locations. The permanent locations are updated periodically by the Unix update daemon. Logs are bounded in size, which is 128 kilobyte in the current implementation. Given Petal's allocation policy, a log will be composed of 264 kilobyte fragments on two distinct physical disks. When the log files, frangipani reclaims the oldest 25% of log space for new log entries. Given the size of the log and typical size of frangipani log records, which is from 80 to 128 bytes, the log can fill up between two periodic sync operations. If there are about 1000 to 1600 operations that modify metadata in that interval. Now I'm going to talk about running recovery on server log. If a frangipani server crashes, the system eventually detects the failure and runs recovery on the server's log. Failure may be detected either by a client of the failed server or when the log services ask the failed servers to return a log it is holding and gets no reply. The daemon finds the log start and end, then examines each record in order, carrying out each described update that is not already complete. After log processing is finished, the recovery daemon releases all its logs and frees the log. The other frangipani servers can then proceed unobstructed by the failed server, and the failed server itself can optionally be restarted. To ensure that recovery can find the end of the log, a monotonically increasing log sequence number to each 512 bytes block of the log is attached. Now I'm going to talk about the single recovery daemon per server. Frangipani ensures that at any time, only the recovery daemon is trying to replay the log region of a specific server. The log service guarantees this by granting the active recovery daemon an exclusive lock on the log. If a sector is damaged such that reading it returns a CRC error, Petal's built-in replication can ordinarily recover it. If both copies of a sector were to be lost, or if frangipani's data structure were corrupted by a software bug, a metadata consistency check and repair tool would be needed. In both local Unix file system and frangipani, a user can get better consistency semantics by calling fsync at suitable checkpoints. The next portion is the log service, which will be discussed by Tanvir. Thank you.
Thank you, Uncle Orko, for giving me the floor. Now I'll be talking about the log services. Frangipani requires only a small, generic set of functions from its log service. So many different implementations could be fill its requirements. Three different log service implementations are applied in the course of the Frangipani project, and other existing log services could provide the necessary functionality. The log service provides multiple reader, single writer logs. Logs are sticky. That is, a client will generally retain a logs until some other client needs a conflicting one. When a client first contacts the log service, it obtains a list. All logs the client acquires are associated within the list. Each list has an expiration time, currently set to 30 seconds after its creation or last renewal. Network failure can prevent a Frangipani server from renewing its list even though it has not crashed. When this happens, the server discards all its logs and the data in its cache. If everything in the cache was dirty, Frangipani turns on an internal flag that causes all subsequent requests from user programs to return an error. The second implementation stored the log state on a PETL virtual disk. Writing each log state changes through the PETL before returning to the client. If the primary log server crashed, a backup server would read the current state from PETL and take over the to provide continued service. With this scheme, failure recovery is more transparent, but performance for the common cause is poorer than the centralized. In memory approach, automatic recovery is not fully implemented from all failure models for the implementation before going on the next one. The third and final log service implementation is fully distributed for fault tolerance and scalable performance. It consists of a set of mutually cooperating log service and a clerk module licensed strings. Individual logs within table are named by 64-bit integers. Recall that a single Frangipani file system uses only one PETL virtual disk, although multiple Frangipani file systems can be mounted on one on the same machine. Each file system has a table associated with it. When a Frangipani file system is mounted, the Frangipani server calls into the clerk, which opens the log table associated with the file system. The log server gives the clerk a list identifier on a successful open, which is used in the all subsequent communication between them. When the file system is unmounted, the clerk closes the log table. Clerks and the log service communicate via asynchronous messages rather than RPC to minimize the amount of memory used and to achieve good flexibility and performance. The basic message types that operate on the logs are request, grant, revoke, and release. The request and release message types are sent from the clerk to the local server, whereas the grant and revoke messages types are sent from the log server to the client. Thank you. Now, Sakibul Islam will continue the rest.
Well, thank you so much, Tanvir, for giving me the floor. I will talk about the backup portion. Here, PETL snapshot feature provides us with a convenient way to make consistent full dumps of a Frangipani file system. PETL allows a client to create an exact copy of a virtual disk at any point in time. Furthermore, the snapshot copy appears identical to an ordinary virtual disk, except that it cannot be modified. The snapshots are crash consistent, that is, a snapshot reflects a coherent state, one that the PETL virtual disk could have been left in if all the Frangipani servers were to crash. Hence, we can backup a Frangipani file system simply by taking a PETL snapshot and copying it to a tape. After that, when a Frangipani server receives a request to release a barrier lock, it enters the barrier by blocking all new file system calls that modify data cleaning all dirty data in its cache and then releasing the lock. Moreover, the new volume can be accessed online to retrieve individual files, or it can be dumped to tape in a conventional backup format that does not require Frangipani 2 for restoration. Petal snapshots are currently read-only. In the future, we may extend Petal to support writable snapshots. After that, the performance portion. Frangipani's layered structure has made it easier to build than a monolithic system, but one might expect the layering to exact a cost in performance. In this section, we show that Frangipani's performance is good in spite of the layering. Firstly, single machine performance compares how well Frangipani's code path compares with another Unix VNode file system, namely Digital's advanced file system. Table 1 gives results from the modified Andrew benchmark, a widely used file system benchmark. The first phase of the benchmark creates a tree of directories. The second phase copies a 350 kilobyte collection of C source files into the tree. The third phase traverses the new tree and examines the status of each file and directory. The fourth phase reads every file in the new tree. The fifth phase compiles and links the files. Secondly, several Frangipani servers simultaneously run the modified Andrew benchmark or independent datasets. The x-axis gives the average elapsed time taken by one Frangipani machine to complete the benchmark. We notice that there is minimal negative impact on the latency as Frangipani machines are added. In fact, between the single machine and six machine experiment, the average latency increased by only 8%. Thirdly, the experiment measures the effects of write and read sharing on files. One or more Frangipani readers share varying amounts of data with a Frangipani writer. Read ahead is disabled in this experiment. With smaller block sizes, throughput is even smaller. After that, we come to the conclusion part. The Frangipani file system provides all its users with coherent shared access to the same set of files, yet is scalable to provide more storage space, higher performance, and load balancing as the user community grows. It remains available in spite of component failures. It requires little human administration, and administration does not become more complex as more components are added to a growing installation. That's all for us. Thank you so much.